हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? वेलकम टू सरस्वती शिशु कुंज बगवाला बोरसर। टुडे आई एम गिविंग यू सेशन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड थर्ड सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश। ओके, ऑलरेडी यू हैव लर्नड चैप्टर 1, 2, 3, 4 एंड 5। सो नाउ यू विल थिंकिंग
Are you ready to learn this poem? Okay children, you know the what is the name of this poem? Yes, good morning. So now I will sing this poem and you will also try to sing and repeat after me. Okay children? Good morning sky. Good morning sun. Good morning little winds that run. Good morning birds, good morning trees, and creeping grass and brownie bees. How did you find out it was day? Who told you night had gone away? I am wide awake, I am up now too. I'll be right out to play with you. I'll be right out to play with you. Good morning. Good morning. Again, you also have to sing with me continuously. Okay, children? Good morning, sky. Good morning, sun. Good morning, little winds that run. Good morning, birds. Good morning, trees. And creeping grass and brownie bees. How did you find out it was day? Who told you night had gone away? I am wide awake. I am up now too. I'll be right out to play with you. I'll be right out to play with you. You love this poem? Yes, this poem is on morning, right? What is happening in the morning? In this poem, you will learn these new words. You can read downside. CREEPING, creeping. AWAKE, awake. GONEAWAY, gone away. Okay, children? So you will learn this poem with next slide. Good morning sky, good morning sun, good morning little winds that run. You know who is singing this poem? One child, one girl. Okay, the child is singing this poem of good morning. Why she is singing this poem? Because the child wants to wish them. Okay, the child wants to wish all of them to whom she is seeing in the morning. For example, in first line, she is wishing to the sky, then sun, then little winds that run. Okay. Good morning, she is wishing to everyone. to sky, to sun, to little winds. She says good morning to them. Good morning, birds. Good morning, trees and creeping grass and brownie bees. Now again she is wishing to birds, trees, creeping grass and brownie bees. She wants to say good morning to birds and trees and creeping grass. What is the meaning of creeping? You know, children, moving with the body close to the ground. Grass is coming out from the ground, right? And grass moving up from the ground. So that is called creeping grass because it comes out from the ground. Brownie bees. As you know, bees are insects and those colors are brown. So that's why brownie bees. Brownie means brown color. How did you find out it was day? Now the child is thinking that how they all understood that now the day arise. Who told you night had gone away? She is asking to them that how you understood, how you know that night had gone away and now the day arise. Now the day is coming out. How you all understood? I am wide awake. I am up now too. I'll be right out to play with you. Now the child is asking that how you understood that night gone away and morning arise. So now it's morning. So I also awake means I also wake up. And I am also ready to play with you all. Why child want to play with them? Because already morning arise and she wants to play with this all. To whom with the, is she wants to play? Yes, she wants to play with. To whom? Anyone can tell? Yes, to the sky, the sun, wind, birds, trees, grass, brownie bees. Okay, she wants to play with this all. So now let's learn one new exercise. Rhyming words. What is rhyming words? When we are speaking, the rhyme should be same. Okay, the tone of the words should be same. See the examples. Bees, trees. Bees, trees. Day, play. Day, play. To, you. To, you. Sun, run. Sun, run. These all words already taken from the poem only. It's not from outside. These all words are available in the poem of Good Morning. Now the next exercise. See, there are two lines. One line of day and one line of night. What you can see in daytime and what you can see in nighttime. Now let's learn this. In daytime you can see sun, bees, birds. Sun, bees, birds. You can see in daytime. And what you can see in nighttime? Moon, stars, bats. Moon, stars, bats. Bats is a bird, okay, which you can see on the tree. So again I am repeating, daytime you can see sun, bees, birds. Nighttime you can see moon, stars and bats. Now next exercise. Nature walk. What is nature walk? Means what you can see in nature. It is natural things. What you can see. Okay. So here you can see six words. First one is flowers. Second number, sun. Third number, butterfly. Four number, bees. Five number, trees. And six number, birds. These all you can see in nature. These all are natural. Okay, so that is called nature walk. So here I am finishing my slide walk. So now get ready for the question answers.
Children, see this word meanings. Okay, in this poem there are three words. I return these three words meanings. Okay, the first one is creeping. What is the meaning of creeping? Moving with the body close to the ground. Again, creeping, moving with the body close to the ground. Okay, this is creeping word and its meaning is moving with the body close to the ground. Whatever things are there, it's connected with the ground and it's closer to the ground with their body. That is called creeping and it's moving also. The second one is wide. Wide means a great distance away from each other. Wide, wide, wide open means there is a distance between, you can see, wide distance between two things, okay, with each other. That is called wide. Awake, to come out of sleep. In the morning, you are waking up, right? So that is called awake, means you are come out of the sleep, means now you are wake up. Okay, now children, see some question answers. Now let's see some question answers. Answer the following questions. Only three question answers are here. So, and these all are very easy. So don't worry, you can learn it by heart very easily and very fast. Okay, the first one is, why is the child in the poem happy? Again, why is the child in the poem happy? Children, you saw the video. So now you understood that why child is happy. What is the reason? What is the reason of child's happiness? Okay, so the answer is because. See children, you can write like this way. The child in the poem is happy because. Then you can write the answer. Otherwise, you can write directly from the because word. Okay, it will be short. Otherwise, your answer will be very long. So I made it very small. So you can start with the because word. Remember, children. First of all, you have to write first letter of the answer will be capital, and at the end of the sentence, full stop. These both are compulsory. Okay. So let's see the first answer. Because it is morning now and the night is over. Why child is happy? Because already night is over and now what begins? Morning. Okay, morning starts. Now it is morning time and already night is over. So you can write the answer like this way. Because it is morning now and the night is over. The second one is, to whom does the child say good morning? Okay, to whom does the child say good morning? Children, you saw in the poem that child want to say so many that good morning, good morning. To whom he wants to speak like this way? To whom child wants to wish good morning? So the answer is, the child says good morning to the sky, the sun, wind, birds, trees, grass and bees. You have to remember these seven words. To whom child wants to say good morning. Okay, so again I'm repeating, child wants to say, the child says good morning to the sky, the sun, the wind, birds, trees, grass and
Children, are you ready to learn this poem? You can see the picture. What is the name of this poem? The Balloon Man. Okay, you can see this slide, and this is so colorful. You can see one balloon man with lots of balloons, and he has lots of colorful balloons, right? So let's get started. He always comes on market days. Balloon man comes always on market days, right? When the market is full of carts and vendors and all, and all over there in the market. So like that day, always balloon man comes in the market and holds balloons a lovely bunch. You can see, children, balloon man holds a lovely bunch of balloons. Bunch of balloons means so many balloons together in a one bunch. Okay, so you can see the bunch in balloon man's hand, right? And he holds it. Okay, and in the market square he stays. Acha, balloon man, where the balloon man stays means where he is standing at the market square, where all four sides cover with the buildings or shops or anything. So between that there is a square place. So over there the balloon man stands and never seems to think of lunch. We are thinking that he is always standing on the same place in the markets. So when he is going for lunch, he is thinking for lunch or not? He is going to lunch or not? So in this poem, balloon man is hardworking and he is standing for whole day to sell his balloons and without taking care of his lunch. They are red and purple, blue and green. Now we are talking about balloons. Okay, what are the colors of the balloons? Red, purple, blue, green. You can see more colors, yellow, orange, right? So balloon man has lots of colorful balloons with him. And when it is a sunny day, you can see now it's time for sun. That's why it is sunny day, means afternoon time. So on that time also he is standing on the same place selling his balloon with happy face. The carts and people get between where he is standing. Over there so many carts and people all around, and he is standing in between and selling his balloons very happily. You see them shining far away. When the people get tired and sitting somewhere else, from the very far away also people can see the balloons. Why? Because balloon man holds its balloons. Balloon man hold his balloons with lots of colorful bunch, right? And whenever people are standing, they can see the shining from far away. Wherever they are standing, from that side people can see the shining balloons from far away. And some are big and some are small, means balloon size will be not same. Definitely some will be big and some will be small. You can see some balloons are big and some balloons are small. All tied together with a string. How balloon men hold it? Like one bunch, right? But with a string. String means a thread. He is using a string to tie this, and together he is taking in his hand and making a bunch of balloon with the string. And if there is a wind at all, if the wind is coming, so what happened? The balloons, what happened? Balloons, yes, they are flying highly and very speedily because there is a wind. They tug and tug like anything. Means tug means they are becoming joint with each other. Okay, when the wind is coming, balloon tug and tug means tied and joined with each other with the wind. Someday perhaps he'll let them go. Child is thinking, children is thinking, children are thinking that if someday perhaps the balloon man will leave the balloons in the sky, then balloon man will let them go in the sky, then what happen? And we shall see them sailing high. Means after that, when the balloon man will leave them up, we will see them in the sky. We will see the all balloons will be sailing in the sky. They will sailing high in the sky. And stand and watch them from below. We will stand downside, we will stay below, and we will see, we will watch them, how they are flying, how colorful balloons flying in the sky and how they are looking. They would look pretty in the sky. Definitely all the colorful balloons will be in the sky if they will be fly in the sky. Okay, so children, definitely they will look beautiful, they will look pretty, right? Because they are colorful, and colorful balloons will look very pretty in the sky. Now children, let's learn some jumbled words of this poem. Now first of all, learn that what is a jumbled word. You can see the numbers 1, 2, 6, right? See in first row, there are the letters are here and there. They are not in proper way. They are not the proper spellings. Okay. The first one you can see, double L, A, B, double O, N, S. What is this word? Nothing. So we have to make it correct. We have to arrange the letters in the correct order. And then we can make the correct spelling. See, the first answer is B A double L double O N S, balloons. The second one is U L B E. So the answer is B L U E, blue. Third number is W O L B E. So the answer is B E L O W, below. Four number is C U N L H. The answer is L-U-N-C-H, lunch. Five number is P-L-O-E-E-P. The answer is P-E-O-P-L-E, people. Six number is C-R-A-T. And the answer is C-A-R-T, cart. So in the first column, the letters are here and there. And in front of them, we return the correct spelling, means jumble words. Okay, now let's see another exercise. Wow, so colorful balloons, pink, yellow, green, blue. But what is there in the balloon? Yes, there are opposite words. Okay, children, first you can see in the pink balloon, N-E-V-E-R, never. The opposite word of never is A-L-W-A-Y-S, always. The second one, blue balloon, S-M-A-L-L, small. The opposite of small is B-I-G, big. Third yellow balloon is R-A-I-N-Y, rainy. And the opposite of rainy is sunny. S-U-N-N-Y, sunny. Fourth yellow balloon is L-O-W, law. The opposite word of law is H-I-G-H, high. Fifth balloon, green balloon is S-I-T, sit. And the opposite of sit is S-T-A-N-D, stand. The sixth balloon, blue balloon is near near the opposite of near is far. So now once again let's read this poem and you will learn it very easily if you will read this. Okay, simultaneously you have to also repeat after me. The balloon man, he always comes on market days and holds balloons a lovely bunch, and in the market square he stays and never seems to think of lunch. They are red and purple, blue and green, and when it is a sunny day, the carts and people get between. You see them shining far away, and some are big and some are small, all tied together with a string. And if there is a wind at all, they tug and tug like anything. Someday perhaps he'll let them go, and we shall see them sailing high, and stand and watch them from below. They would look pretty in the sky. Okay, children, enjoyed this poem? Yes, because it is colorful balloon man poem, right? He is bringing colorful balloons with him and he is also wearing colorful clothes. So balloon man is also colorful. Am I right, children? Okay, so learn it carefully and now let's get ready for next.
Children, enjoyed the colorful video, right? I know you enjoyed because it was very colorful. The balloons were also colorful, right? So now it's time for question answer. So I'm explaining you question answers. Okay. The first question: where does the balloon man stand? As you have learned from the poem, where was balloon man? Yes. The answer is the balloon man stands at the square of the market. Okay, where there is a market on the place square place was there. Over there the balloon man was stands. Okay, so the again I'm repeating the answer. The child points to the balloon man to let loose the balloons in the air. He wants to see them flying high in the sky. So these all answers are very easy. First and second, simply it's very easy. Third, little bit difficult, but when you will learn, you will get easy answer. Okay? And you will see this video again and again. So you will see the colorful balloons with balloon man, and you will learn these question answer, all exercises, and you will enjoy it very much. Okay, children? So